Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. So we just got an update that Stable Diffusion 3.5 model just got released and we have a day one support inside of ComfyUI. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to set it up, what are the models, where to place it, and how you can use it locally on your machine. So here's the article from Stability AI and says introducing Stable Diffusion 3.5. As you can see, today is October 22nd for me at the time of recording, and this article as well is October 22nd. So we got a day one support inside of ComfyUI the moment that the model got released. Now this particular model is the large model, and then we have a turbo version. They've also mentioned that they will be releasing a Stable Diffusion 3.5 medium on October 29th. Now, all of these models should run on consumer hardware, as it mentioned. Obviously, you will need a minimum requirement, which I'm going to talk about. But the main thing that we need to know here is that this is available for both commercial and non-commercial, as long as you're following the Stability AI community license. And basically the community license says that it's free for research, non-commercial, commercial use, as long as that individual is making less than $1 million annually. Now, obviously all the links will be in the description below, so you can go ahead and read it at your own time. Now, this model is quite large. It's around 16 gigabytes in size. So you can give it a try on your machine, but I'm going to say you will need at least 32 gigs of CPU RAM. And I am going to test it on a 12 gigabyte VRAM card. In case you're not able to run it, you can still try it out by going on HuggingFace page. Of course, I'm going to leave the link in the description below. And then scroll down, look for Spaces here, and then click on anyone that's available. It's going to open the free space that you can give it a try. There are not a lot of features for you to experiment with, but it should give you a quick preview of what you can expect from this model. All right, so let's take a look at a couple of image generation with Stable Diffusion 3.5. So this is the default prompt that comes with ComfyUI, but right away I can tell that it's quite different from the previous version. And here's one where I was trying to get a clock, a man, and I wanted it to be surreal type of image, and as you can see it came out really well. Okay, so here's an abstract type of image. Here's another one. This one is supposed to be some kind of park. This one came out different from what I was expecting. My prompt was a geometric pattern which converges towards a portrait, and this is what it came up with. And I'm actually really happy it came out really well. This one I wanted to try something minimalistic. So I said a dark circle on a white background, and this is what it gave me. Actually, we have the dark circle, we have the white background. Gave me a little line. I'm not sure what the clip interpreted the text, but this is quite good. This one is supposed to be some kind of fantasy, and this is where I started trying to do with realism type of portrait. Now, this is not quite there yet. This is my second attempt, and from far we can see that this is AI generated. It's not realism at all. So I played around with the text prompt until I was able to get this one. Now, if we ignore the hand, we can give it a pass. And then another generation, again, for the realism, this is another one. Now, of course, if we take a look, a close look at the feet, I believe there are 9 toes on the left foot itself. So obviously, when it comes to hands and feet, AI is still have difficulty generating them. Now, try again with a comic style. So obviously it can do comic style. It can also do anime style. All right, so we've established that it can do a lot of variety, different styles. So now let's take a look at how you can get this on your system. So go into the description below. There will be 3 links. The first one will be for Stable Diffusion 3.5 large. Once you're here, at the top here where it says, well, for me, it says you have been granted access, but For you, for your first time, you will need to agree to the license. And it will look something like this, where you will need to put your name, email, and fill in all of these information. Make sure to check this box and then click on agree and access the repository here. Now, once you're here, click on files and versions. In files and versions, scroll down until you see the example workflow. So click on this little download icon to download the workflow. And then for the model, you will need to download this SD 3.5 large.save tensors. It's around, as you can see here, 16.5 gigabytes. So to download it, click on this download button. Once the download is completed, it will probably be in your downloads folder. So press Ctrl X, cut it, and then go inside your ComfyUI folder. Inside of ComfyUI, inside the models folder, and then go inside checkpoints folder, and then paste the save tensors file here. So as you can see, I have the SD3.5_large.save tensors here. Now, similarly, in the description of this video, there will be another link for the large_turbo model. Same thing, you will need to agree to the license, go inside files and versions. Of course, make sure to download this example workflow. Click on this button here and then download the turbo version. Click on the download button here. Now, we are not yet completed when it comes to downloading checkpoints. If you do not have the clip G, clip L, and this T5XXL FP16, go into the description of this video and download them. Once you've downloaded them, move those clips save tensors file inside the model clip folder, like so. All right, so once you're at this point, make sure you are updating your ComfyUI. If your ComfyUI is already open, you can go inside the manager and then click on update all, or even update ComfyUI. If you like to do it from the ComfyUI portable folder, you can go inside that folder, inside the update folder, and then double clicking on update_ComfyUI.bat. If you have not updated your ComfyUI in a long time, then you can click on this update ComfyUI and Python dependencies. All right, next, find the two workflows that you've downloaded, one for the large and the other one for the turbo version. Most likely, if you click on the download button, it will be in your downloads folder. I have these two files here. I'm going to click on the SD large example workflow first. Click on it, drag it over on top of ComfyUI and release. It will load the workflow. Okay, so starting from the top left, we have the load checkpoint, and this will be for the SD3 large or the SD3 large turbo checkpoint. So both of these checkpoints, you will use the load checkpoint node to load them. All right, so from the dropdown, just select either the large or the large turbo. They are both the same size. The only difference is that this large will require a high number of steps. From my testing, I went to 40. That was the default. And then this large turbo can generate images as low as 4 steps. Now, here is the triple clip loader. Now, for Flux, we were using the dual clip loader. This one uses a triple clip loader. So we'll need to load all three of these clips. So the first one will be the clip G, and then clip L, and then the last one that we have is the T5XXL FP16 one. As of right now, the FP8 version is experimental. You can give it a try if you're not able to run the FP16 one. Okay, moving on, we have the empty latent for SD3. This is where you'll change the resolution. And there's a little note here that you need to make sure that your resolution is a multiple of 64. Now, then we have the normal clip text encode. This is going to be positive. Don't bother with the negative prompt. It's going to be zeroed out anyways. So similar to Flux, where we don't use the negative prompt. All right, at the top here, we have the model sampling for SD3. Now, when it comes to the key sampler, if you've chosen the normal SD3 large dot save tensors, then make sure that your number of steps is going to 30, 35, 40, depending on the sampler and scheduler. I'm going to have another video out where I'm going to test out these samplers, schedulers, and see which one works best at how many number of steps. So if you have not subscribed to the channel, you may want to subscribe to find out the result. Now, if you've chosen the SD 3.5 turbo version, then change this to 4. Otherwise, you can go ahead and click on the cue prompt and basically just have fun with it. So here are a couple of images that I've generated. Now, when it comes to text, Flux is still better in my opinion. So let's see a couple of results from Stable Diffusion 3.5 when it comes to text generation. So this is one I was trying to say Stable Diffusion 3.5. As you can see, it failed. So I changed the resolution so that it has enough space, but it's still, it's not great. Diffusion is misspelled here. And then I tried again until I was able to get it to spell it correctly. All right, so this is just a quick video, a quick introductory video on Stable Diffusion 3.5. It is quite late for me today, so tomorrow I'll probably experiment with it some more. Like I said, I'm going to try to find out what is the best samplers, schedulers to use, and how low we can go with the number of steps. There's obviously a lot to experiment with. So stay tuned, take care, have a nice day, and I will see you in the next one.